Hello. Welcome to the Slow to Learn training video. In this video, we will have a look at how to create structured Word documents in Word 2007. Word 2007 is different from the earlier versions in that it uses a toolbar or a ribbon rather than menus. Otherwise, the principle is the same. To create structured documents, you must apply heading styles to your section headings. You can see if a document has structure by looking at the document map, and you can open the document map by going to the View tab and clicking on Document Map. And then here in the left-hand section, you see there's a listing of all the sections in the document. Here you can see Word was smart enough to pick up on these little section titles that were on single lines in bold, but it doesn't really recognize that they're all at a different level. To really make a document structured, you must apply styles. To do that, simply click on any text that you would like to make into a structured heading, and then here at the top you click in the style menu, you click on the style you want. For instance, we want this to be the top level heading, so we click on heading 1. Then in this section I want to make that heading level 2, so I may click on heading 2. And so on. Here I click on heading 3 because it's a subsection. Here's another subsection title at the same level, and I click on heading 3 again. And you see here that the structure is beginning to appear in the document map. So here you see that the level of heading 1 is here, and then 2 and 3 are underneath it. So you can easily see how your document fits together. Here I can click here and again make that into level heading 3, and that works quite nicely. Again, all of my subsection headings are at the lower level. I can see it at a glance. Now this is very easy, there's nothing to it, and you should really be doing it every time you create a document. But if you do it a lot, it's probably quicker if you learn a keyboard shortcut. And Word has built-in keyboard shortcuts for the first top three headings. You create them by typing Control-Alt, and then the number 1, 2, or 3. So here I go to this section and I type Control-Alt level 2, so Control-Alt number 2, and here's my section 2. I can then go here and then do Control-Alt-3 because that's section heading level 3, and a 3 again, and then finally go to the end, and that's again at the same level as the section 1, so Control-Alt-2 will make that into a section. Well, as you can see, nothing could be easier. And now that I have created the structure in the document, I can simply browse through it or jump from one section to the other by clicking into Document Map, and I don't have to scroll bit by bit. I simply click here and I jump from section to section. Now that you have a structured document, it's also incredibly easy and quick to insert a table of contents. I go to References tab and click on Table of Contents, choose Insert Table of Contents or one of these predefined options, but I choose this one and click OK, and my table of contents is inserted. What that means is that now if I add a new section, that will automatically be reflected here, and also the page numbers will update automatically. That will not only will that save you a lot of time if you need a table of contents for a long document, but now you can also insert a table of contents even in short documents where before you perhaps would not have bothered. Thank you for watching this video. There are more videos on how to create structured documents in other word processor as well as other tech tips for people with and without print disabilities.